Hey, wanting to pop in really quick. I was doing the Q&A on the story, and I kept getting the same type of questions, kept seeing the same questions over and over. And all of the questions kept saying, like, been dating a guy a month. He says he doesn't want a relationship. Should I wait? Should I leave? You know, been with a guy for 10 years, getting divorced. He's not fighting for the marriage. Been dating a guy for a year, hasn't introduced me to his family. Been talking to a guy for 3 months, he only texts me, not call. All of these things. I wish we could air this on national television, and I just want to let y'all know, and I'm only trying to level the playing field so that we can stop wasting time. And we can start building real relationships so that we can raise healthy and happy kids in whole homes. And one thing I need y'all ladies to understand that about men is that when a man wants something or someone, it is evident. If you have to, and listen to me, I don't accept any excuse about, oh, well, everybody shows love differently. Do you have a dog, or do you know somebody with a dog? Go over there, buy that dog, and you will see how a dog shows love. If an animal can show love, and it ain't just dogs. People got squirrels showing love. People got snakes showing love. People got, you know, they pig on their farm showing love. If an animal can show love, a human can show love. But understand this and hear me clearly. If you have to wonder if a man is into you, he's not. If you have to wonder if your man is in love with you, he's not. There, love is or it isn't. There is no in between. There is no halfway in love. Love is or it isn't. Please understand this. A man who is deaf, blind, and mute can show you that he loves you. A man who is mentally disabled can show you that he loves you. Understand me when I tell you, if you are in a relationship or a situationship or friends with benefits and you wondering if he really wants you, if he's really into you, the answer is no. The answer is no. And I know people say, Tony, it ain't that black. It is that black and white. Because time is too precious to waste it on someone who is unsure about what they want. Time is too precious to waste it on someone who wants to sleep with you but say they don't want a title. Who wants to be around you but say they're not ready for a relationship. But they want to take up all your time and, you know, use you like a human teddy bear. Use you like a stress ball, but doesn't want to commit, have a title, and be all in. Listen, stop wasting time. And I want you to understand this because I went through this at 21 years old. And so here I was, I went from an absolute dog to a husband in 10 months because I met the woman that was the one. And every man that I know who has met the one, he changed his life overnight. Who has met the one, not anyone, but the one. And so I need you to understand. And anytime I talk to a man who has been with a woman for years and he has not married her and he is over the age of 25, his answer to me is, I don't know if she's the one. I don't know if I can marry her because of this, because of that, because of that. And he's operating from a place of fear, but he cannot, but because he has a soul tie, because he is attached and because he is somewhat loyal, he doesn't just want to cut her off. And so he kind of is biding his time and he's waiting on a sign. And he doesn't understand that the sign is not going to come because you can't be half in and half out. You got to be fully committed. Either you're going to leave so that you can attract the love for you, or you're going to suck it up and you're going to stay and make it work and choose to create love. And so what happens, a lot of men are looking to find love. When love is not found, love is created. And love is created through communication. And communication is the real love making. Intercourse is not love making. Love making is communication. That's when you're talking, when you're making love to the mind, not the body. And so a lot of men don't know who they are, so they don't know what they're looking for. But even a man who doesn't know fully who he is, when he meets the woman that he's looking for, he will know. And so I need you to understand that love is or it isn't. It shows up and it shows out. And when someone truly loves you, and if you are in love, then you can attest to this and probably leave a comment for somebody else who was confused. When you are in love and you are being loved by someone, you don't have to ask my opinion. You don't have to ask. I'll tell y'all something. A lady, she was on my YouTube comment, and she was talking about, sleeping with her man early, and now 20 years later, they married. Well, that let me know you're not happy, because my wife does not watch relationship videos. She doesn't watch relationship videos because she's 100% happy in her marriage. So she doesn't follow relationship coaches, and she's not watching all of that because she has what she wants. I don't watch relationship videos. I don't go and read relationship books because I have created the love that I want. So I am not seeking. When you are seeking and when you are wondering, that means that something is missing and that there is some work that needs to be done. You know, don't, and now some people just could be bored and just be here for the comments and be in a happy relationship. That can happen. But what I need you to understand that if you stuck wondering and worrying about the way this person feels about you, then they don't really feel too much about you. And you have to sit down and you got to have that moment, that meeting that says, listen, I don't have the time to waste, you know, come correct or don't come at all. Like, let me know what it is. And what comes out of your mouth, let your actions back it up. Like, don't get stuck in a situation to where you just listening to lip service, but you don't have actions and proof and patterns that prove what they're saying. And it's frustrating, but I realize why I gotta stay in the fight and keep doing the work. But it's really mind-boggling to me when I'm receiving questions from women in their 30s and 40s, you know, about these men. And I'm like, wow. I'm like, Lord, come on now. Come on now. Y'all got to have, y'all, come on now. Come on now. Y'all got to do better. Y'all got to do better. Because the kids need you. You know, the world needs you. Stop wasting time with grown boys who don't know what they want. Keep it moving with your life. And I can't make excuses for a man, because I got married at 23 years old. And I was the absolute worst. I played the game worse than anybody that I have ever met. I was all the way out there. You hear me? And so if I got it right, I know every man could get it right. And so I can't make excuses for a man. I don't know what I want, or I ain't ready yet. Well, if you ain't ready yet, keep your thing in your pants. If you're not ready yet, then let that woman move on by her life so she can find a man who's ready. And at the end of the day, ladies, y'all got to take responsibility too. And no, it ain't all on the man.